Good morning, students.
Good morning, ma'am.
How are you today?
I am fine, thank you.
Okay, student, we will learn English. And our topic today is, topik kita yaitu, use can to express an ability. Penggunaan kata can untuk mengekspresikan kemampuan. So what is the meaning of can? Apa artinya dari can? Apa? Bisa. Can is
bisa.
For example, contohnya Andre bisa memasak. Andre can cook. Cook apa cooking? Cook. Ya, coba dilihat di sini. Look at this formula. Lihat formulanya, lihat rumusnya. For positive sentence, untuk kalimat positif is subject plus can plus verb one. Kata kerja bentuk satu, without ing, tanpa ing. Jadi bukan cooking tapi cook. So Andre can cook. Andre can cook or Andre can cooking?
Andre can cook.
Okay. Andre as a subject can cook verb one. Yeah. Any question? Okay. Next, the formula for using can, rumus untuk penggunaan kata can, there are three kinds of formula. Ada tiga. They are positive sentence, negative sentence, and interrogative sentence. For positive sentence, subject plus can plus verb one. Verb one is without ing, tanpa ing. And next sentence. Any question for the first? Ada pertanyaan untuk yang pertama?
No.
And for negative sentence, there is differences. Ada perbedaannya. Look at this one. Cannot. Positive sentence is using can. But negative using can't or cannot. You can choose one of them. Kamu bisa pilih salah satu dari itu. Can't or cannot. Can not. Kalau disingkat jadi can't. Ini can't, kalau ini can. Kalau ini good. Can is bisa, but if there is not, kalau ada not jadi tidak
bisa.
Tidak bisa atau tidak mampu. Tidak mampu. For example, tadi contohnya Andre bisa memasak. Andre can
cook.
But if Andre tidak bisa memasak, jadi Andre can't cook atau Andre cannot
cook.
Bisa ya?
Bisa.
There is any question? Ada pertanyaan for second sentence? Next, the third, yang ketiga, interrogative sentence, kalimat tanya. Here the differences is can at the first word. Can ada di kata pertama. Can plus subject plus verb one plus next sentence. Can see there is differences. Can at the first word. So the meaning of can see to be bisakah. Ya, bisakah, karena bertanya. Kalau tidak bertanya tetap bisa. Kalau tidak bisa jadi can't. Kalau kalimat positif can. Kalimat introgatif can, tapi artinya
bisa.
Oke, for here any question, ada pertanyaan di sini?
No.
Oke, next. I have example. Three example. Saya punya tiga contoh. Aji can speak English. The positive. Aji can speak English. Aji here can speak English. Bisa berbahasa Inggris?
Yes.
Aji can speak English. Aji as
subject.
Can speak as verb one without ing ya, tanpa ing. And English as of object or the next sentence. Lanjutan kalimat. For the positive sentence here, showing an ability, menunjukkan kemampuan. Ini three of you, tiga dari kalian. And move one by one, maju satu persatu to make sentence. For positive sentence, negative sentence, and interrogative sentence. Here there is a sentence. Imam bisa bermain sepak bola. Who can move one by one? Siapa yang maju? Okay, very number one. Imam can play football. Is it right or wrong? Right. Imam as
subject.
Can as ability. Play as verb one. Football is the next subject. Ability. Verb one and object or next sentence. Frankie, for negative sentence, move forward. Silakan maju. Imam cannot play football. Is it right or wrong? Right. Okay. Thank you. Sit down. Imam as subject. Tan ability. Play bebuan football
object.
Next we'll move Alia interrogative sentence. Okay, stop here. I ask you, saya tanya ke kamu, why can here at the first word? Kenapa can di sini ada di pertama? Because can us can sebagai kata
tanya.
Can us a question. Give a round for Alia. Can is an ability. Imam us
subject.
Play verb one. Football is
object.
So positive sentence is using can, but negative sentence and interrogative sentence can at the first word. Kata can ada di pertama kalimat. Any questions, students? Frankie, you have any questions?
No.
If you don't have any question, I think that's all for today. See you.